Okay, okay, thank you.
Just watch it, that mic is quite sensitive.
Yeah, yeah, I will watch it. Okay,
okay.
Hello, everyone. We are going to get started in about a minute and 30 seconds. So you've got about a minute and 30 seconds to find your way to your seat, get comfortable. I can see there are still lots of seats available upstairs. If you prefer to stand, you can stand just in the corner here at the back of the lower level, or the corner there at the back of the lower level. We're going to get started shortly.
Once again for a long-awaited music celebration.
Although my anticipation for this day stretches back even further, actually. I don't know if my students even know this, but the last time that the Limestone District School Board music students and teachers gathered like this was right here in this very hall in 2007, and I was a high school music student at that time. And I was right over there on the choral risers, hey, and I was, you know, waiting nervously for this thing to get started as somebody else was up here speaking and introducing things. And I'm just really being overcome by a thrilling sense of deja vu. I'm walking around the room and I'm seeing many of my past high school teachers, some of them who are retired, some of them who are not yet retired, some of them will be retired soon. And I'm just so overjoyed that I get to be here now as a music teacher joining fabulous music colleagues, because it is such a joy to watch these musicians. And I look around the room and I just see every music teacher with a smile on their face, just so proud of the musicians in front of them. So can I just have a thank you to all of the music educators who are here with me?
Thank you.
stiff. I'd now like to call up and welcome Christina Michi to the stage. Christina is from the territory of the Shabbat Obadjuan First Nation and is an Indigenous student support and engagement teacher for the Limestone District School Board. She is also a talented multi-instrumentalist, and in addition to sharing her expertise with our French horn section today, she has led all of our musicians in an original piece she created called Ninundun Aki Ni Gabo. And this title is in the Algonquin language and translates to I Hear the Song of the Earth. Uju Christina, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you.
so excited. You big witch. Thank you, Christina. That was beautiful. I'd now like to introduce my colleague and fellow music teacher, Mr. Evan Jackson, who led our guitar ensemble today. Evan is a local musician. You can find him on Spotify. And also a graduate of the Limestone District School Board. Mr. Barton is also an award-winning recording artist. So take it away, guitars, and Mr. Jackson, thank you.
Thank you.
to one of my high school music teachers, Mr. Ian Juby, who is guiding our vocal group today, so our vocal group can start to get ready there. Mr. Juby is a talented musician, vocalist, and artistic director of the Kingston Choral Society for over 20 years. And I'd also like to introduce Sophie Thabili, who's a current Limestone teacher, who is also a playwright, actor, director, and vocalist. And together they have expertly guided our vocalists today. And finally, I'd also like to introduce our magnificent student accompanist from KSS. This is Javin Lau. Tonight, we are going to hear two pieces from the vocal ensemble. The first is a piece called Shine Like Stars and has words and lyrics by Pink Zebra. And the second song you may recognize from the hit Barbie movie and is called What Was I Made For? With words and lyrics by Billie Eilish and Phineas O'Connell and arranged by Andy Beck. And if you just give me a moment, I'm going to go over there and complete my experience of deja vu and go join them and sing. Well, that was fun. I've totally forgotten what I'm supposed to be doing now. I was just taking in that moment. Thank you, vocalists. It's really cool to hear the harmony resonating in this hall. I want to take a moment. You may have noticed that we're all wearing these fancy t-shirts today. And these t-shirts were actually designed by a Limestone District School Board student. We had a contest, and I want to do a big congratulations to Lily Nichols of NDSS, who created this fabulous design. Lily was just singing with us. Where's Lily? Would you mind standing up so we can give you a big round of applause? And this musical experience is much bigger than any one of our schools could offer. So I'd like to give a big shout out to our event sponsor, the Limestone Learning Foundation, for their significant donation of $10,000 to make today happen. And I'd like to call up Kathy Leverett of the Limestone Learning Foundation to share a few words with us. Thank you.
Resulting in this much anticipated presentation. We all know that music improves confidence, resilience, brain function, and is a total brain workout. There's a scientific proof that listening to or making music increases the blood flow to parts of the brain that generate and control our emotions positively. So the Limestone Learning Foundation board members celebrate all of you, your instructors, your leaders and teachers tonight. Let the workout continue.
Thank you, Kathy. I'd also like to send out a huge thank you to our other event sponsors. Firstly, to Queen's University, the Dance School of Music and Drama, and Dr. Julia Brooke for generously granting us this space as well as our rehearsal spaces today. I'd also like to thank Mr. Tim Ryan and Long and McWade. Hi, Tim. Tim's running the sound booth for us over there. Long and McWade generously donated Tim's time, sound equipment, and instrument rentals today. Well, I think, Tim, you visit all of our schools on an almost weekly basis, repairing things, bringing us instrument accessories, so thank you so much, Tim. I'd also like to thank the Joe Chetlin Music Instrument Lending Library for the loan of several percussion instruments today, and Tourism Kingston for generously allowing the incredible gift of Moira Demarest. I'm not sure where she is right now, but she has been the hugest support in this endeavor, and we'll chat a little bit more about her later. So, yeah, thank you. Next, I'd like to introduce another music teacher who was here back in 2007, who also led the strings back then, Ms. Kendra Brennan of Bayridge Secondary School. And she is going to lead our small but mighty string ensemble in Merry-Go-Round of Life from Howl's Moving Castle by Joe Hisashi. I think I said that wrong. Hisashi? Joe Hisashi. And arranged by Jen Mathers. So take away strings.
Thank you.
brand new teacher in Limestone who just made her conducting debut in front of all of you. So thank you to Maya for that. Also a Limestone music graduate. So it's very special to have the strings because not all of our schools actually have string programs. So it was really wonderful to gather all of these string players today and collaborate together. Thank you, Ms. Brennan. I'm now going to direct our attention to this massive concert band in front of us. I'm so excited to hear them play for you. I think this is, what, the biggest concert band you've been in before? Is that correct?
Yeah.
Have you been in a bigger band than this? All right, this is the big concert band. So today we had over 20 professional clinicians working with our students. We started in individual instrument sessions, having small ensemble lessons with professionals in alto sax and oboe and French horn, etc. But tonight we've got the very talented Mr. Hugh Johnson, who is going to be directing this group. And Mr. Johnson is also a retired music teacher and the conductor of the Youth Orchestra in Kingston. He's a trumpet player, and he's also a Juno Award winner for Music Counts Teacher of the Year. So we're very privileged and excited to have him here conducting us this evening and to have had him working with our musicians throughout the day. So today the concert band is going to be performing two pieces. The first is a celestial composition titled Nebula, composed by Randall D. Stanbridge. And this piece beautifully captures the enigmatic expanse of space. The second piece is called Tripwire by J. Rod Hall. And you should listen as a spy attempts to infiltrate the defenses of their archenemy. Take caution though, for every step can trigger an alarm as tripwires are everywhere. Please give it up for Mr. Johnson and the Limestone Music Conference.
Thank you.
LDSB senior staff, Mr. Jeff Pesnick and the Specialist High Skills Major Program, for committing to investing in our students' music education. In the last 2 years, our school board has invested in our programs by updating our instrument inventories with brand new instruments. And this investment helps ensure that our programs can thrive and that students have working instruments to hone their skills. So a huge thank you, Limestone, for that. I'd like to now introduce, it's my honor to introduce, our Director of Education, Mr. Krishnabura, who is here to share a few words with us tonight.
Wow, that was incredibly impressive, all of you today. I know we're not done yet. Very impressive, and it's been about 30 years since I've heard music in this room, and this old hall still does a pretty good job. Good evening, everyone. The Limestone District School Board is incredibly proud of this event, the community collaborations, and the opportunity it has created for the Limestone District School Board students to thrive and excel in their musical endeavors. It was the vision of the Limestone trustees for a more comprehensive and inclusive music program that led them to invest $500,000 in surplus spending for secondary musical instruments, arts programs, and the Artist in Residence program in the fall of 2021, when we were at that stage of the pandemic where we weren't quite sure where the light was at the end of the tunnel and music programs had suffered so much. This support from the trustees at this time recognized the need for an infusion into the arts and secondary music programming, knowing arts funding has not been prioritized through provincial grants in recent years. And budget feedback from the Limestone community consistently emphasizing a desire for more arts programming to support their learning. The supplementary funding enabled secondary schools to expand their music curriculum, invest in new instruments, and repair and replace supporting infrastructure. As one Limestone District School Board teacher, who may have had the mic right before me, said, "Tonight we want to show everyone that the investment in music and the arts was extremely valuable and will have an impact for years to come. Thank you for the funding and support." The goal of this evening is to continue to build community within the arts and music across the Limestone District School Board. Music teachers tried to select music that is from a wide variety of styles to help each student see themselves in the material we are working with. Having the opportunity to work with music professionals and clinicians is something that very few students would be able to access without an event like this. Today is also a great way for students to see a few different pathways for themselves beyond high school, where they could continue to participate in music making and learning. As we all know, providing students with the opportunity to learn the music and then perform it, all in one day, I might add, for audiences as large as this, is a very unique experience. With close to 400 students participating, it continues to be an evening and experience that none of them, nor us, will forget. As we all know, events like this do not happen just by accident. They take lots of intentional work and effort. And I'd like to acknowledge the organizing committee, primarily consisting of Limestone Secondary music teachers. Amber Brennan, Marcy Statnick, Kelly Caravan, Kristen Martin, Tim Stiff, teacher candidate Ben Reed, expanded opportunities and specialist high skills major teacher Jeff Petznik, Julia Brooke, director of the Dan School of Music and Drama at Queens, and Moira Demarest from the city of Kingston. I'd also like to acknowledge and thank several key sponsors and supporters who made the event come to life this evening. The Limestone Learning Foundation, of course, along with Long and McQuaid Musical Instruments, Dan School of Music, the City of Kingston Music Office, Queen's University, and the Bayridge Secondary School of Computer Science Program for live streaming. And finally, just another kick at music, I'd like to highlight that the Kingston Kiwanis Music Festival will take place in early April. There'll be classes in piano, strings, bands, choirs, guitar, voice, and wind instruments. As usual, experienced out-of-town adjudicators will give feedback on each performance that will highlight a range of local musical talent among students. Registration information can be found on the Kingston Kiwanis Music Festival website. Thank you everyone for joining us tonight, and thank you Limestone students and teachers for bringing us the joy of music. Enjoy the rest of the evening.
Organizing committee for just a couple more thank yous. Days like this don't just happen, so we gotta thank the people who put this all together. Ms. Marcy Satnick, I'm passing it over to you.
NDSS. I'm just stalling for a second while Sir Tim Ryan from Long McQuaid comes to join us on stage. As you've heard over and over, it takes a great deal of work, commitment, time, and a whole lot of people to make this happen. And we would be remiss in not thanking Tim Ryan for being here all day today and also last night, and again after the show tonight. He's taking care of all of our sound needs. He's donated equipment to us free of charge so we can use it. He comes to our schools all the time. He's our great support, and we all really appreciate him. And so if we could give a big round of applause to Tim Ryan.
With our location in Kingston, we're able to provide a one-stop full-service center right here, including sales, rentals, repair for guitars, and yes, repair for band. The teachers are laughing. It's our job to support your schools, the teachers, and students as best we can to support all your musical needs, to help you succeed with the programs you have, like the SHSM program, and the hope of new programs that may develop in the future. With that being said, Long McQuaid will be awarding one of the lucky students here a $100 gift card to our store. And the way we're gonna do that is all the teachers and everyone involved are gonna submit your names to me, and I'm gonna draw one at random, and you will be notified. Thanks for all the hard work you put in, especially to the teachers and the students.
Thank you. My name is Kelly Kierman. I'm a teacher, music teacher at KSS, and I haven't done very much speaking tonight, so I won't say very much, but we would be remiss as a team if we didn't thank the person that kind of brought us all together. Everybody in this room knows that music teachers have lots of skills, right? Lots of skills. There's some skills that we do not have. And for these skills, we called upon our glorious Moira. That's all I have to say. She just sweeped us together and made sure that every little detail that you can possibly think of, down to the lights in the room right now, she helped us remember and just know what to do, and he brought this whole thing together. So everyone who's in this room right now, parents and students and teachers and support people, and thank you so much for being here. But it's because of Moira. We had a very, very wide vision. Moira brought us together. Thank you, Moira. Thank you so much for making this happen.
It's a great thing to be considered capable by your peers. And so I decided to just take some time to think upon it. And as I was telling the students, summer started, as they usually do, with approximately a couple days or a day in Canada Day. And I remember hearing people around a flagpole randomly singing O Canada. And it just got me thinking as the days went on that the original, the unofficial anthem to O Canada was a piece called The Maple Leaf Forever. And it was written in 1874 by Alexander Muir, a music teacher. It was meant to celebrate this relatively new country and the growing sense of national pride. Unfortunately, it immediately alienated and offended some groups. And though Mr. Muir rewrote the words and he tried to make amends, the damage was done, and he was left with that. Now, that was a different world, and it was a different Canada. So I decided to start with Muir's tune of The Maple Leaf Forever, and his original intention, but from today's perspective. His words reflected his Canada, but not our Canada, and it was from that thought that the title was born. I've tried to imbue my own sense of values in the lyrics, which reflect our Canada, the Canada that we know now we have inherited, but we also know is within our hands to mold and to shape into something truly worthy of national pride. It's up to us. Now, the opening bars are set without beat, and we have invited this incredible percussion section to try and, with their instruments, reflect the natural world. Not the natural world, the uninhabited one, but the one that the indigenous have taught us to respect and to honor. Traditional chords come in and change the landscape until the solo trumpet enters with the main motif, the tune. The musical landscape suddenly changes to one that uses contemporary rhythms to carry the tune, while the percussion section drops in dynamics. It's tough though, right? They're just so keen to go. And then they continue on with this traditional ostinato. The band finishes its statement and hands the idea over to the strings, the guitars, and the voices. And then they take the tune, but also with the newer words, the newer lyrics. The strings and voices are accompanied with the same rhythm in the percussion section, but a decidedly different sound. The singers now have the opportunity to read words into the melody, giving it a new and more defined identity. Now, as the band joins back in, the music modulates back up to the original key, heightening the intensity as the singers restate the final time their message to share this land where now we stand. O Canada, our Canada, the greatest of all nations. I truly hope you enjoy the efforts of these wonderful limestone students. And we thank you. We thank you all. I know what it's like to be a parent with the minivan going back and forth. We thank you all for supporting them. On behalf of myself and all the music educators and our entire team, I want to thank you, and I also want to state what a privilege it is to be able to work with these young musicians each and every day. So thank you very much, and I will go back and take my spot for the final performance of the day, folks, I promise. Our Canada.
Greatly appreciate that. But at the very least, if you can stack your chair, thank you so much.